Hello viewers, it is my esteemed pleasure to welcome you to yet another episode of our YouTube tutorial videos. So in this tutorial video today, I'm going to show you how to place a skylight in your roof. And in that simple exercise, you're going to appreciate first the various benefits that accompany the use of skylights in our various roofs. So before we proceed with this simple exercise, I'll wish to remind you to kindly subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you may not miss any of our upcoming updates and tutorial videos that we'll be putting up in this particular platform. So the first thing that I need to do first is to ensure that my floor plan is in place. And as you can see, I have it, and I just want to select the various points that I'm going to have my skylights positioned, because fundamentally we know that skylights help in enhancing the natural light to penetrate inside the structure, and also that it also helps to ensure that there is enough ventilation for a particular building. And you need to appreciate that the skylights are mostly relevant non-load bearing structures that will be found on top of the roofs in any particular direction that a designer may use to, or rather may wish to have it placed. So the first thing that I'll do is to activate the skylight tool, which I'll locate on the left side part of this tool panel. Then once I locate it, then I will click on it to activate it. Then once that is in place, I will locate it in the control panel, or sorry, the settings dialog. Then I'll click on it there. Then I'll first select the kind of skylight that I wish to use for this design. So I preferably like the skylight pyramid. So I'll click on it. Then I will go to the settings dialog where I'll be able to make some few settings to this skylight pyramid before I position them to the roof. So that is the preview position, how it looks like. So I'll first adjust some necessary dimensions. I will have this this skylight as let me have it as 4000. It should be a bit long. Then I'll adjust the width to say 2000. I'll adjust it to 2000. That will be okay. Then once that is done, the constant of the roof will remain in horizontal position, of course, to ensure that it is rightly positioned in its place. Then the next thing that I'll do is to go to the skylight settings, having ensured that the nominal width and the nominal height is 2000 and 4000 respectively. I think that will be okay. Then the next thing that I'll do is go to the general settings. Then I'll make sure that I have the linings and edge clicked. Then I'll ensure that this is perpendicular, of course, for the alignment, and also this one should remain perpendicular. Then the surface, I'll change it to let me say glass mirror. Then no, let me have that as white, of course, for enough penetration of water, or sorry, of light. Right, then put that as glass clear, then I think the plaster will be okay. Then that one, I think I can go to the dimension marker. Of course, it's okay, so there's no problem with that. Then I'll go to the tag, and for the tag I need to define some few things here to ensure that the structural function is defined. So I'll click on it. Then I'll define it as non-load bearing. We will not wish that it carries any load. Then on the position, I'll also define it as exterior. It will be on the exterior part of the roof. Then once that is done, then I will click OK. And then to ensure that now I'm able to now define my skylights in position. Then there's something also I need to add is the fact that we need to align them to the main ridge of the house so that there's some consistency and uniformity. And I think that will be okay. Then I'll also decide and put one here. Yeah. So the next thing that I'll now do is to now just position them appropriately. So I'll click on it. Then I'll move. Just drag it. Drag it into this. Just make sure that it is almost aligning. If it's not aligning to that particular ridge, then I'll also come to this and click on it. Make sure that I drag it. Then just there. Then I believe we can still do something with the dimensions. Simply ensure that they are in line. So that line is only showing me that the two skylights are aligned and they are all occupying the same axis, the x-axis. So the next thing that I can do is to just play around with the dimensions. I think I can maybe adjust this to 45. Okay. See how it comes. I think that is okay. Then okay. Also change this to 45. Yeah. So we can look at it on the 3D. Just look at it on 3D, see it is coming out as we want. So from the 3D, I believe you can see that it's quite adorable. It's quite adorable, same to this. So there's something that I need to add as far as the positioning is concerned. The fact that most of the skylights should always be around the work areas. As you can see, I've positioned mine on the corridor, like this corridor heading to the kitchen. I've also this corridor that is heading to the master bedroom. So I believe that you're able to see some sense as far as the natural lighting and even the ventilation is concerned. As you can see, the other areas are provided with windows, so that means that ventilation is quite adequate. But now for the corridors that may lack a means of natural lighting and also ventilation, you can always give provision for the particular skylights in position. And I also need to add that, as you can see, the skylights enhance the outlook of a roof. So I believe that also tells you that they are quite value-oriented because they are able to add aesthetic value to the roof of the house. So I've come to the end of this tutorial video. I wish to ask from your opinion in case of anything that you wish to add or even subtract from this tutorial video. Kindly share it in the comment section below, and also please do not forget to subscribe and like and even share this tutorial video so that we can be able to add more value to our upcoming tutorial videos. For now, thank you and see you in our next video.